Welcome to India Podcasts.
Almost all industries will get affected. What we are doing is trying and assessing which are the industries which will get more severely impacted, which will be less severely impacted. You know, there is ample liquidity with the banks, and it is proving to be a challenge to be able to effectively deploy. Post-COVID now, the situation is that there is a complete shutdown in industrial activity.
Yes.
So at the moment, the borrowers themselves are not clear how this will pan out and how they should rework their business model. So I think it's really a wait and watch mode for everyone.
Welcome to another episode with me, Anku Goyal. Banks have played a crucial role as a facilitator in the unique global crisis. State Bank of India, being the first PSU bank to open a credit line, is now assessing ways to help industries manage the lack of working capital. Today joining me is State Bank of India Managing Director Arijit Basu to elaborately discuss the bank's approach and how are they assessing the situation to get out of this crisis. Listen in. Thank you so much, Arijit, sir, for sparing time for our listeners today. To begin with, sir, in this scenario where things have been defined as unprecedented, uncertain, what is your understanding into the situation which no one was prepared for until now?
Okay, for the banking industry, like any other industry, I think this was an event which was completely unforeseen. So, as you rightly said, no one was prepared for it.
Hmm.
But we need to assess how things will be going forward. That also is very difficult because so many uncertainties remain even now. Say, for example, first let us take India. When will the lockdown be lifted? In what manner it will be lifted? Globally, there are so many things. Different countries are facing the virus in different ways. As you know, Indian economy and Indian banking industry is not insulated from the happenings that take place across the world. So global supply chains, our ability to export, our ability to import, all these factors will have a major role to play. So for a bank, for example, we need to look at both sides, our deposits, our liabilities. Deposits, as of now, for our bank, it has seen a healthy growth, maybe a flight to safety. But in case of advances, that is where, or loans, that is where we see the maximum risk.
Okay.
And we are planning for the risk. We are working with our customers, trying to understand what their requirements are. Many measures have been announced by the regulator, by the government. And as you know, our bank, State Bank of India, had also taken very proactive measures. We were the first to announce a 10% COVID line because we realized that working capital would be something which each of the good clients also would need. So one point at this juncture is to state that there were many companies which were doing well. And if you look at our own balance sheet and the balance sheet of most banks in India, they were much stronger by the end of March 20.
Yes.
In spite of there being some slowdown even before that. But the stressed asset scenario, etc., had been managed quite well. And economy and the banking industry was looking or was poised for a takeoff before this COVID happened. So now what we are doing is trying and assessing which are the industries which will get more severely impacted, which will be less severely impacted. Almost all industries will get affected. There can be only one or two which might benefit from this, like pharmaceuticals or medical equipment. But barring that, I think each and every industry will get impacted. But we have to see how to support them and what they can also do to support themselves.
So a pertinent question there comes is, there's enough liquidity in the system, when I say banking system, because despite reducing the lending rates, depositors have been believing in their banks who they have been associated for a while. Is this, are you able to match this with your lending, because risk aversion or risk taking a decision based on not increasing your risk beyond a point is also a very crucial decision on the banking point of view. So how are you looking at that part to match your liquidity, which is quite high with the banks, and also having an equal or a similar proportion of lending going on?
Right. Good question. So there are one or two data points that I can share with you. you are right that, there is ample liquidity with the banks and it is proving to be a challenge to be able to effectively deploy.
Sure.
But one data point that I can share with you is our economic research department has also brought it out that in the month of March, across the banks, there had been a significant spike in the lending that happened in the month of March. And if you would recall, March broadly was unaffected by COVID. We were having the lockdown 25th March and till at least 15th or 20th of March, normal activity by and large were going on in most sectors and industries. So it's not that, so banks were coming back into shape. The reason why there was muted credit growth in the previous months prior to March was partly because the economy was also not growing at a very rapid pace. It was growing at a fairly slow pace.
Yes.
We know that this year we were expecting to end at around 5%. But however, the banks had taken off. We had taken various initiatives and it was slowly coming back.
Sure.
However, post-COVID now, the situation is that there is a complete shutdown in industrial activity. In this scenario, two things are happening. One is banks should be willing to lend, but at the same time, the borrowers should also be willing to borrow.
Yes.
So at the moment, the borrowers themselves are not clear how this will pan out and how they should rework their business models. Right? So what is happening is people are estimating, depending on which industry they are in. Say if they are in the industry of malls, setting up retail malls, they are calculating when it will open, even after opening, what will be the footfalls in the initial stage. Therefore, how will the cash flows get impacted? The cash outflows will still remain. Part of the cash outflows will be for meeting their overheads. Part of it will be for meeting their liabilities, dues to banks and all that. That part is getting taken care of because the Reserve Bank has also allowed moratorium.
Yes.
Banks are lending liquidity support. So as far as banks are concerned, what we have done in this situation is contacted the entire array of borrowers that are on our books. So if you look at State Bank, we have close to 2,200 corporate borrowers, starting from mid-corporate or the smaller of the
mid-corporate
to the largest corporate, not only in terms of rating, but also in terms of the size of the corporate, right? So it could be a 50 crore exposure going up to thousands of crores of exposure. The entire range is with State Bank of India. And what we find is that we have reached out to all of them. They say two, three things. One is, at the moment, some of them, of course, who are fairly strong in conserving liquidity and have sufficient cash, they have said we are on a wait and watch mode. At the moment, many of them have not even taken the deferment on the term loan that we have offered because they don't need to. Because the deferment also has a cost. Because while the dues are getting deferred, there is an interest.
There's an interest.
Which will be applied. There's an interest cost element. So, but some of them have asked for it because they may not have so much of cash. That is one way in which we are supporting. Others have asked for some kind of a liquidity support. So that also, we are doing a reassessment of the working capital limits and trying to see what is their cash budget projection till the month of December.
Okay.
But you have to understand that this also is happening in a period of uncertainty.
Yes.
We are not sure. Normally, when the corporate submits their projection, there is a reasonable degree of certainty about how it will grow. The last year the growth was 15%, so this year in a conservative way also I can project 15%, and we look at that, accept that, and all the calculations are done. At this moment they are not able to do that, so they are doing the best possible estimate that they can do, and we on our part are examining them and supporting them. And as you already know that we were the first to offer immediate succor to each of the corporates by giving them that additional line,
credit
which was offered to all standard assets which were standard, a working capital line of 10% of their existing limits was offered. And that also has been taken by not all, but some of the corporates. In fact, what we find is that while sanctions are up to a certain amount, the drawings are around one third or one fourth of that.
Okay.
This is how the things stand as of now. And I think it will evolve as things go forward and we have more clarity. As you know, the government is also slowly opening up.
Yes.
And we know that this phase, the lockdown is still 17. In some of the troubled hotspots like our own city, Mumbai, there could be a tighter opening up. That is, it may open very gradually because, you know, it is
the number of cases
showing cases are still not yet tapered off. But certain other places might open up much faster. One good news in this scenario is that culture seems to have done very well.
Yes.
And there is a lot of, and most districts, thankfully, are also much less affected.
Mm.
I think more than 200 districts are not having any cases and are in the green zone. So I think it's really a wait and watch mode for everyone. But in this period, what we are doing is we are doing our own risk assessment of what can be the range in which various industries, various companies will, and therefore what will be the risk on our own book.
So there, when you're saying that industry also is in an uncertain situation, they cannot see through the major concrete picture of their own industry. How much do we see the NPA burden coming up? Because we were on a recovery path. I think NPA recovery had taken a upward trend until January, February to say. So now we are glaring at a piling on NPA by default because of the ecosystem and pandemic situation. So are we prepared to deal with it with the provisioning pressure and overall scenario turning around?
We have to look at it in two ways. One is, why do I say my balance sheet is much stronger? Because in all the stress that I see, I have been able to significantly deal with them or made adequate provisions for any losses that might have arisen or that might arise, right? But at the end of March, what we were finding was that the number of corporates, in at least in our bank, in SBI, which were stressed, had significantly come down. Okay, it had come down to a handful, I would say, companies, and which, as you know, there is a way of looking at it, companies which are in SMA 1 and 2, or even say SMA 0. The numbers are very, very, had come down.
Okay.
So the now, when I am going forward, the companies which have been so far showing resilience till March and have been doing well, and they have been themselves holding out, they have been growing, and they have paid all their dues to the banks, we will think that they are relatively more, that their business model is right, and they were in the right direction, but COVID has hit them also.
Mm-hmm.
So there will be one strategy for such companies.
Mm-hmm.
And for those companies who, as I said, their numbers were really small at the end of March, but who were nonetheless under some degrees of stress, we feel that going forward, they may face a bigger challenge, right? So what we have done is we have, when we are doing our risk assessment, we are bifurcating this. So this small category of clients is our immediate greater concern, because they are the ones who were, irrespective of COVID, showing some signs of stress, and we were working with them to see how they are able to come out of it. But their cash flows were in any case a little bit strained. So what we are trying to see is in which industry they are. Again, it will be done on a case-by-case basis. But we find that the good news is that as of now, the number of such companies are very limited. And depending on how quickly they are able to come out, provided some support is given, they are able to come out. But in case some of them are not able to come out of it, I think at least our bank has the balance sheet resilience to be able to take care of them. And the larger set, which is virtually all companies in India, which are going through a bad phase because every activity is shut. So the best company also is not able to do any business, is not able to do any activity. So even they will be affected. But our sense is that as things ease out, these companies will be able to come out of the problem and take forward.
So will the rating have a major impact on the lending or advancement by the banks? Because the rating might go down considering the business has been locked down or shut down for a while. So the rating agencies do have their own parameters for weighing it down or downgrading. abruptly some of these companies which have been performing very well for a long while now.
Right. So rating agencies have their own way of looking at things, and certainly their primary role is to say what is the risk. When they give out a certain rating, they are basically signaling what is the risk that resides in lending to that company, right? Mm-hmm. So it would be, as of now, of course, you are aware that only because of COVID, if there is any situation, they need not actually decrease the rating. But rating, so as I said, we have to look at both the things. Rating, we will have to take it that both the, for at least 2020-21, the profit and loss and balance sheet of almost all companies were to be affected. However, again, the way things will move out or take shape from Q2 onwards, right? Hmm. So Q1, as you virtually know, Q1, if at all, June will be a month when people will just about be able to restart and try and restart activities, which even in some sectors, even that may not happen,
exactly.
Like travel or aviation, it will, those kind of things. Q2 onwards, Q2 will be the quarter in which there will be expectations of some kind of activity revival. But then we have to see whether, hopefully, touch wood, the disease also will slowly go away and there is no this thing. And then you have the second half of the year, which is usually the period when India does well. But most of the activity happens in the second half. So one thought process, but it is too early to say, is that maybe post our festive season, which is the second half, things will pick up. But even if things pick up at that time, there is global uncertainty on how things will move. So this year, the balance sheets and profit and loss accounts of the corporates will be stressed. And that may or may not have any impact on the rating. Mm. Because the rating agencies also do not look at only one event or one quarter. Mm. Unlike, say, the stock market, the rating agencies take a more balanced and nuanced view.
Holistic.
But to come to your question, so we will obviously look at the ratings, but just because a rating has down, as long as we are satisfied that the external factors which has led to this, and otherwise the company is got a good business model and is resilient and is working in the right direction in terms of restarting the activity and getting things on board, we will continue to support those companies. Because if we don't do that, those companies will get affected, and we also will not do ourselves any favor, because it will ultimately have an impact on our own performance and balance sheet. So I don't think that will be a challenge, you know, that just because if some rating comes down, and some ratings have come down, but we are looking at the intrinsic value of the company, and as of now, in fact, SBI also is fairly well placed in terms of investment grade. Most of our exposures are either to investment grade or to government or government-backed entities.
So one question is, at this point, I think banks have played a major role. They have been on the front foot, to say so. Is there an understanding that banks have only played a major role here when it comes to lending or filling in, even when saving some of the crisis companies when they go into crisis? State Bank of India particularly, we have seen many, many cases where they have come forward and rescued them. And in this scenario, bank as a whole, the industry has stepped up to fill in that liquidity gap and played a major role taking hit on their books or balancing it out somewhere. So do you think this has banks have taken a major onus on themselves alone, or other lending institutes have also got a role to play which is yet to plug in the space which is required at this point?
So when we have stepped up, we have done it to support the companies, yes, and we are happy that we have been able to do it. But it is also, you know, something which we have done looking at our own interest.
Okay.
And our interest is to protect our risk. So if balance sheets of corporates and if that we have lent to are stressed, okay, and get stressed due to certain external factors, they need support. Of course, selectively we have to see how much support they need, how much of the additional funds that they have they will be able to sustain and make it viable. All those things we are examining. But if you suddenly withdraw support or step back, then it is not only doing a disservice to those companies, you are possibly doing a disservice to yourself. So one of the a smart credit assessor or a smart risk manager, credit risk manager would always keep this in mind. So I would not really necessarily call it an onus. So whatever we are doing, we are very clear that we are doing it, yes, to support the economy. Let's say we have done a lot.
Even NBFCs, I think banks have already opened up.
Banks are going up. But again, we have opened up liquidity and reaching out to them.
Yes.
But it is also in my interest. If I don't support him now, or if RBI, say, had not given the deferment, then it would not have helped the NBFC. It would have had a cascading impact on the entire system. So whenever support has been extended by SBI and other banks as a whole, it has been in the interest of the corporates as well as in the interest of the banks themselves. RBI has already announced, I think twice or thrice they have given.
TLTRO.
First round there were deferred TLTRO, deferment in term loans, reassessment of working capital. The array of instruments were fairly extensive. Government has also announced measures. They have given one set of measures was to give some succor to the poor people, the credit to the Garib Kalyan Yojana and things like that. And they are in active discussion with industry to go forward. RBI has also been talking to us and also proactively easing up the interest rate scenario. Right.
Sir, the listeners want to know this from you now, particularly since bankers have been going to office every day during the entire crisis. How has lockdown come to you? Has it been difficult at times? And we saw a recent case, few banks including SBI did find certain cases being identified and taken precautions accordingly. So what goes into your mind when you're moving out of the house every day and coming back with the satisfaction that we've done enough today?
Thank you for that question. I think first and foremost, I'd like to thank each and every colleague of mine in SBI and the entire banking industry that we were classified as an essential service for obvious reasons. And the entire banking industry, SBI, we ourselves rose to the occasion virtually from day one of the lockdown. The kind of things that have been done are really, really significant. Our people, our IT systems itself, we have a large set of people who have to work together. Almost they were working at one-third capacity. But in this entire lockdown period of more than 50 days, there has hardly been any disruption. And on top of that, what they have managed to do is they have managed to give the credit to all the Garib Kalyan in State Bank. There were almost 8 crore such accounts in which credit was afforded.
Mm-hmm.
We were able to do it in the month of May. And yes, they have really taken a lot of personal initiative. They understood that there is a risk. But there was a lot of care also taken by them for both the customers as well as themselves. They kept the protocol. The government had set protocols. They followed the protocol. We have set up mobile ATMs in many places. And while doing all this, touch wood and with the grace of God, we have been able to, unfortunately, ideal situation would have been no one would get infected. But considering the staff that we have, the numbers who have so far got infected are very minimal. And both on the serving the customers on the retail side and also on the corporate side when corporates have reached out. You know, in the first COVID line that State Bank gave, in the month of March. So some of the corporates said, yes, we want to do it, but we can't even go to your branch and we can't even send anyone to do any documentation. So even we relaxed the norms around that. So I think wonderful work has been done. Like in all other essential services, of course, the healthcare workers are in the front line. But I think bankers as a group have been one of the most significant who have really stepped out and given human service. It is certainly different from normal times, but I think this was necessary for the sake of the country and the world. And I would hope that, you know, all the hard work that everyone in India has done would ultimately pay off, and this will slowly taper off. You know, the cause, it will come out of it. I'm quite sure that everyone, all the people who have risen to the occasion, they will be rewarded by ultimately things panning out for the good.
Thank you so much, Arijit sir, for speaking with us and expressing all your views to our collaborators. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anku. It was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you for the understanding of the banking industry. And do stay safe and take care.
Thank you so much. Uncertainty has kept all the options of banks open, as the opening of lockdown will help understand the recovery time for corporates. Arijit Basu believes that State Bank of India is much prepared to absorb the impact of crisis as measured up until now. Keep listening for more voices on India Podcast. You may now follow us on Spotify, Spreaker, Apple Podcasts and Google Podcasts. You may also subscribe to our YouTube channel and Instagram handle, India Podcast. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay indoors.
Brought to you by India Podcasts in association with ICI Healthcare for Pure Care Sanitizers.